Hey, hello, Alex here, Roadster Alex, and today I'm going to show you quickly how I did all the gauges on my M2 Spyder, which is all the way over there. I'm outside, it's not too bad, I just want to go over, you know, how I connected it, and you know, maybe it'll help you, so keep watching. So here's my car, as some of you know it. So inside I have three gauges: oil temp, oil pressure, and white bands. So I'm still not turbo, but I decided, because I want to know if something is wrong with my car, how to do it. So I'm going quickly over it, how I did it. So to start with, that's my oil temperature here, oil pressure, and boost. Those are three ProSport gauges that I bought before, if you might have seen in one of my videos. Because my screen is here, hello. So because my screen is here, I decided to move them here. And my parking sensors, when I finish them, have them, I'm going to put them just there with a nice plate over it and everything. So that's basically my plan. So what I did to connect them, I extended all the wires because they were way too short. So here's one, there's another one, and there's another one. So I had to extend them for about a meter or so. Basically, normally you should connect those to permanent life, and then there's one for the ignition switch. At this stage, the power I connected just to the ignition life for those two. This one is mounted correctly to the permanent life as well. So because those are daisy chain gauges, you only need the power supply for one of them. The other one will power the other one. Unfortunately, the daisy chain for the boost and the AFR is different than the one for the oil, so that won't work. However, I just connected one, which you can see here, that one. That's currently a temporary, the power. And then it goes little one, which you see over here, which basically this gauge is powering that one. Then the sensors are here and the sensors are there. Because I extended them a tiny bit too much, I went all the way through there, all the way to the back, and then here, and then under there. Went to here. Here is my, it's just temporary for now. This is my AFR. Because it had to connect it to permanent life, I put it here. But I'm actually thinking of cutting this out, then putting this one on the other side, and then make a little button just for this, and that's, you know, you don't need more, so all the cables can go through nicely there. So basically, if you let me show you, if you take out this tray here, there is a big plug in the back of it. You would have to open it, so take all the, you know, all the plastic off, cut it open, and that allows you to put the cables through, which I only did for my oil temperature, my oil pressure, and my boost. Those are the only three I put through there, because it's very, very, very tight. Those were the only ones I could get through there. Now for my AFR, I actually went, if you can see there, that you see the big black cable there. I put it all the way basically through there, over, and then you can go all the way to the back here. I will open the bonnet back here for you to show you how it looks. So you can see that it comes through here. So it just sits there. Normally I have it, you know, with a tie grip or something, to here. And then it goes down there, and then it goes in there. So that's how I set it up. And then the other white band, the normal one, goes here and there. I don't need it anymore later. And you can see my boost sitting here, the sensor, then wires, the filter. And that cable goes through there, as you can see. If you zoom in a bit, that's how they sit. The reason is because the oil temp isn't really the longest one. I don't want to extend those cables. So I decided to put them through there, and it actually works very, very well. Then for the AFR, I needed a permanent lathe, which I basically went, took the cable, put it through there, and it goes in the back of there where is a nut, and I put my nut there too. Then there is ground, which is this one is actually for ignition lathe, which I didn't connect. Then the ground is the brown one, which I connected to this grounders too. Ignition lathe would be is a bit harder, but what I found was this cable, the right one in this case, is ignition lathe. So I decided to just tap it from there, and it works absolutely amazing. So it's quite easy, as you say. It's just, you know, connect the cable there. You could put some you know, some seal around it, but I'm not finished yet. Plus, I want to see if I can move this anyway somewhere else. And battery is going to be moved because my water to air intercooler will be sitting here. Anyway, this is very, very quick how you connect, you know, the gauges to your car. So if it's not helpful, I'm sorry, quick video. But if it is helpful, if any questions, you know, don't hesitate to ask. So that's it for today, folks. See you next time.